Hi guys, David Benavisi, one of the biggest names in boxing, one of the top 10 Pop-1 fighters on the planet. What did Adrian Broner just post? He overcame what?
What is his Instagram?
Adrian Broner. Did you find it?
Oh, this one, okay.
He says what he overcame. What does it say?
Bankruptcy, toxic relationship, alcohol abuse, sexual temptation, gambling, baby mama drama, drug dealing temptation. Verbal abuse, weight gain, COVID, self-depression, mental illness, frenemies, court cases, house situation. Damn, I don't even want to finish it.
Porn addiction, club addiction.
But it's true, but I give him props. He beat all this and he's back.
Yeah. Shout out to Broner, bro.
He's a good dude. Good energy.
I used to love Broner too, man.
But he's not lying.
So look, I got a funny story about Broner too. It was before I was so... I had seen him before I fought Ronald Grovell the first time for the belt. It was like a couple weeks before that, and he was like being really motivational to me. And I felt good hearing that because at the time he was like one of my favorite fighters.
Four division champ.
And then I see him in the when I fought Grovell in the back room. I'm like, hey, bro, like I just want to tell you I appreciate everything you told me. Like I really I listened to it all and I really took it to heart. He's like, man, I was fucked up. I don't even remember that. I'm like, oh, that's fucked up, bro. Like,
he's messy. He's a jokester. He was just playing.
I don't think he was playing.
he remembers everything.
But yeah, he's. I mean, it's still even though I
4-time division champion.
He's a nice guy. He's a nice guy.
130, 135. 40, 47. 40, really nice guy.
Listen, the one thing that I feel like a lot of fans missed out on, which would have been an amazing fucking fight, was him and Matisse. Yeah. Remember he was supposed to fight Matisse after Maidana?
I remember.
That would have been a fucking dope ass fight.
Listen, 2 in the morning, we're driving in Cincinnati. He pulls over right by homeless, and this is not for a selfie. Like, look at me, I'm giving the homeless money. And he gives all the homeless money from his own heart. Not for clicks, not to post.
Yeah.
And he goes in a grocery store and he tells all the families in front of him, I'm paying for all the groceries. Like, he does stuff like that.
That's what's up.
There was a kid in the gym, true story. Maybe the kid's 9 years old, but he's wearing shoe size 14, like 5 sizes too big. So Adrian goes to him, what size shoe are you? And the kid goes, I'm size 14. His brother was shot and killed, and those were his brother's shoes. But the kid's really size 9. So Adrian goes to Foot Locker, buys like 5 pairs of Air Jordans for this kid. You know, you come to a gym full of kids, it's like piranhas, they're all running. He's like, nope. Tells the kid here, all these 5 pairs of you.
Oh shit! Yeah, that's what's up, man. That's what like when you got a big heart like that. That's why he's been so successful. He's made a lot of money, because the universe gives back. You give back, and the universe is gonna give back to you.
But he's not lying.
That's why I always tell people, it's not. Don't ever be a piece of shit. And don't ever fucking think that you're better than everybody, bro. You're not. You know, if it's better that you give back and you be a nice person, because at the end of the day, that shit all comes back.
That's true.
It all comes back to you.
I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting.